ISO? What the heck am I in search of? I'm not looking for anything. Hello, and welcome to DIY in 5. My name's Trisha Hirschberger, and today we're going to teach you about one of the three pillars of photography, ISO. If you want to learn about the other two pillars, aperture and shutter speed, be sure to subscribe to see those videos when they come out. First things first, what is ISO? In basic terms, ISO is the level of sensitivity to light in your camera. The lower the ISO, the less sensitive it is to light. A higher ISO increases the light sensitivity of your camera. So what does it mean to have more or less light sensitivity? With increased sensitivity, your camera can capture images in lower light without using a flash. And that's a good thing, right? Well, there is a drawback. Your photos will have more grain or noise when you raise the ISO. Here's an example of the same photo with low ISO and a high ISO. You can clearly see extra noise with the higher ISO. Now that we know what ISO is, which setting should you use? For the best image quality, use the base ISO. In other words, the lowest ISO your camera can go. Usually that's either 100 or 200 depending on your camera. What about when that's not possible? Let's say you're indoors without natural light coming in. Well, that would be a great time to raise the ISO. Each time we raise the ISO, it effectively doubles the amount of light sensitivity in the camera. This is why your ISO settings are in increments of 100, 200, 400, 800, and so on. Just remember, the higher the ISO, the more potential noise will be in your photo. So how do you know what to set your ISO at? Many of us starting out will use the auto ISO settings on our camera, and that's perfectly fine. But what if we want the cleanest image possible, even in low light? It's simple. You just need to lower your ISO, put the camera on a tripod or flat surface, and use a longer exposure. We'll cover exposure and shutter speed in future episodes. But once you've mastered that, you can create some cool long exposure images like these. You may have noticed some cool blurring effects with those photos. What happens if you don't want that? That's where the higher ISO settings will help. Anytime you want to quickly capture image in lower light, raising your ISO will help. If you have kids or pets in dimly lit rooms, or just want to freeze the action of any photo, increasing the ISO can help here. You won't get the cleanest image possible, but it will definitely help you achieve the intended look of your photo. Boom! There we have it, ISO checked off the list. Let us know what other photography questions you have in the comments below. And if you still need more DIY tips, check out these other great photography videos. I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and I know what I'm in search of. The photographer at the nudist colony. All his pictures were overexposed.